Okay, so I think I've done something pretty cool. I don't know if it's, you can tell me if you agree or disagree, but I've gone ahead and I did this whole session basically where I took Serum and I linked a bunch of parameters to the knobs on this little MIDI keyboard I have here. This terrible thing. I'm recording myself. Let me just disconnect the mic. Hello? Get rid of that mic. Okay, get. Okay, now, I had this whole session. I took a basic preset in Serum. Let me just show you what I did. Is I linked a bunch of these parameters to different things. See this knob here? It affects the how much FM. This one is the low pass. So this one is, and this one just is how much FM I'm using with the second channel. These two here, these are for the comb filter. So I'm going to go into FX. I have a comb filter on here. This one is just the cutoff, so where it is on the frequency spectrum, and then this one is the range. This one is the pitch. And this one is how fast the notes go. And then I did that. I basically had it so it was recording just one. I was just recording the Serum track into my DAW here. And then I took a bunch of these sounds and exported them. I started with a different LFO shape, and then I ended up with a sound that sounded kind of like an 808. So I changed the LFO shape to be 808 shaped. And then I ended up completely by accident creating probably the best 808 sound I've ever heard, so. So that's how it started. Then it got onto stuff like this. You know, basic stuff. Cool shit. You know how it is. Nothing but the swaggiest gangsta sounds there are.
Yeah.
And here's me starting to play with the LFOs. You can see it's starting to look like an 808 in the waveform here. So you get the idea. I then took a bunch of these sounds, exported them to a folder, and then I opened them up in Ableton, actually, because I've downloaded the trial version of Ableton, and I've been messing around, because it has very cool stock plugins that I just don't have in FL. I used the amp. I'll just show you what I did. But, yeah, I used the amp preset, which is really cool, and shoved it through a whole bunch of different plugins and exported. And then I ended up with a really neat sounding 808 that I've been using for the last couple days. And I just wanted to show it and share it with you guys. And if you want to download it, there's going to be a link down in the description to get it. It's tuned to C, so you don't have to tune the 808 yourself. It has limited application. I think it's the kind of 808 that you would want to use specifically for like a hard hitting like XXS Tentacion kind of beat, or like Smoke Perp or something. Not like some chill track, if that makes any sense. Let me just open up my recent file here. I also cleaned out my apartment this weekend, so I feel a lot better producing in a cleaner space. I had like garbage on the floor. I was really becoming a mess. I also quit my part-time job, which helped a lot with freeing up time. I have enough money to live off of for the rest of term, so I'm not worried about that. So now I'm just glad that I have free time to focus on music, be that for school or for YouTube or for just for fun, you know? Ableton's not responding. That's why I'm sitting here and rambling. Okay, there we go. I put it through the amp, then I put it through erosion, then I EQ'd out the highs, and then I exported that as its own file tuned to C. So the link to this file and the original files that haven't been tuned, if you look down here, it's on A3 minus... It's a sharp A3, so you want to bring it down by 30 cents around there to get it to be in tune. Set your root note to A and then bring it down by 30 cents, and then you should be good if you want to use the original ones. But I also have one that's tuned and processed. So I made a beat out of it. I don't remember how good this is, so it might be completely terrible because I'm still learning how to use Ableton, so. I think actually that's pretty good. I was listening to it yesterday and it got kind of stale, but I think it's actually a pretty decent beat now that I'm thinking about it. And there's another thing I was working on, is I downloaded these the plugins from Spitfire Audio, and if you're in music, you probably know what they are. And that's it's a very fancy sampler. It's completely free. And some of the sounds in the sampler are not free. But the two things that I am very excited for are the Labs thing, which is community sounds. And there's a whole bunch of neat stuff. I used a choir and a music box in this beat that I'm going to show you. But also it gives you access to BBC Discover Orchestra. It like creates the sound plugin through this service. And it's just so good. I'm not going to show you that because I haven't used it. But this is another thing I'm going to show you before I end off this video. This is just a beat I made today using... how do I turn off show automation? I don't know how to turn off showing the automation. This is me learning Ableton, by the way. Anyways, I'm going to play this beat for you, hopefully. Hopefully it comes off as well as I remember it. It's also on my SoundCloud. So that plucky sound is this music box from Spitfire Audio. It's an incredible sound. And the choir is also from Spitfire Audio. I just put it through a plate reverb. The music box I put through a... I also just put through a plate reverb. And an EQ. It's a simple plugin. And then I've got a subtle pad here. That's just a serum preset that I put through Fracture and Valhalla. Super massive. And then, of course, white noise. But yeah, that's all I wanted to show you for today. Thanks for watching. And have a good one.